The power of opening up can transform your being. Nothing else can transform you. No learning, no teaching. Nahi nahi rakshati tukrunj karane. Shankara says, the greatest intellectual in the spiritual field, understand, in the whole world, there can be only two spiritual philosophies. One who accepts Shankara, one who rejects Shankara. But no, you can't deny Shankara. He is a milestone. He is the greatest spiritual, intellectual guy. If you read his books, you will become tired. You will have shoulder pain, actually. No, really. His logic is so sharp. If you read his books, and actually I have even fallen sick by reading his book, because you will feel your whole energy is drained. Such a strong intellectual. If you hold his books and read, by the time you finish reading, you will have shoulder pain, not because of book weight. You will have shoulder pain and your logic will be tired. Such a great intellectual. He sings in a song, Bhaja Govindam, Govindam Bhaja Mudamate, Samprapte Sannihite Kale Nahi Nahi Rakshati Tukrunj Karane. Let me translate. Open yourself and chant the name of Divine. See, when he says Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja means opening yourself, worshipping, offering. Open yourself to the Lord. No intellectual philosophy, no grammar. Tukrunj Karana means the grammar which you need to learn to study all these intellectual philosophies. No intellectual philosophy will protect you, save you when you are leaving the body. Nothing can help you when you are dying. Intellectual philosophy, if it is related to outer world, it can bring little money and house and comforts and a car. If it belongs to inner world, it may bring little name and fame and arrogance. That's all, nothing else. The philosophy related to outer world will bring little money, good car, big house and comfort. And the philosophical knowledge related to the inner world will bring little arrogance, name and fame, and a good social identity. That's all, nothing more. He says beautifully, Nahi nahi rakshadi tukrunj karane, samprapte sannihite kale. When the last moments of life comes to you, your grammar, your knowledge, your intellect can't do anything. It won't help. Open yourself. Open yourself to the existence. First time I understood all my studies, because I had a big pride that just by studying, just by reading all and having this knowledge, you can achieve something. No. No. When I had my darshan through a old lady, her whole wealth is not more than $1,000. Her whole wealth, her house, cow, everything, clothes, everything, if you put together and sell, it will not be more than $1,000. That's her whole worth. That is her property, life and everything. But the quality of life she is living, I can't explain. Living with God. Understand, she is living with God. I was shocked. I was shocked. Just I fell at her feet and did complete namaskar. She was frightened because a sadhu touching her feet, she never expected. I said, you are my guru, you are my master, because Not only I have not achieved the spiritual truths which you achieved, the height. Not only you achieved, you are able to transmit to somebody just by a touch. Just by one touch, she is able to give that experience. She has become a big inspiration source for me. One more thing. Anyhow, after a few days I left and continued my wandering. After enlightenment, I tried my best to trace her and at least get her photograph. Not only she did not have any photograph till her death, she passed away, that small hut is there still. We tried to get that hut and make a temple in memory of her. Then we came to know she already wrote that small property also to a nearby temple and donated it. She did not even leave that for son or daughter or anybody. She died saying that let this be given to a nearby temple. There was a small temple, Krishna or some god's temple. She gave that also away to the temple before death. So nothing of her was left except that small Krishna deity which she was worshipping, which is there in the temple. See, I can't imagine human beings can be living on the planet Earth just like gods with gods. When I saw her, I understood the meaning of the word living with God. Living with God, with God. Whole our property, our outer world wealth is just $1,000. Sometimes people spend in one day, which they spend in one day for one night dinner, or if they throw a party for birthday party, over. I think if you throw birthday party for $1,000, I don't think people will come. You may do the Last Supper, not nothing more than that. Just a bread and wine, nothing can be done with $1,000. Anyhow, just with whole properties, that's all. But the quality of life she lived, the power of opening up, that's what when Shiva says, listen while the ultimate mystical teaching is imparted, I still, without blinking, at once become absolutely free. He says, some click will happen when you sit with an open being. Something will click, you will feel strongly connected that what this guy is talking is honest truth. I always tell people, people ask me, Swamiji, why should you insist on the presence of the master? These words you can learn from an audio discourse or DVD. No. These words you can learn. But when you sit in front of the master, the honesty which radiates in my eyes, the truth which expresses in my body language will catch you. You will catch it. You will feel that click, that connection. Yes, he is talking the truth. Even if you want to suspect, suddenly you will see your logic has no power anymore over you. Beyond your logic, simply these words are going inside you. Your logic is going, oh, it's going, I'm losing ground. But just these words are going inside. They are just filling you. They are just overflowing in you. This will happen only when you sit in the presence of the master. Upanishad. I always tell people, even if you die in the presence around the master, the greatest thing can happen to you can happen only in his presence. We call that as Upanishad. Just being around, sitting, opening to the master.